come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
And now, from the fabulous entertainment showroom in the heart of Music City, USA, it's time for Ray Stevens' CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guest, Micky Dolenz. And the A-Team. And now, here he is, all ready to monkey around one more time, Ray Stevens.
Running to and fro, hard working at the mill, never fails in the mail, yeah, from a rotten bill.
Too much monkey business, too much monkey business.
Oh, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Well, a salesman talking to me, trying to run me up a creek, says, buy it now, go on, try it, yeah, pay me next week.
Too much monkey business, too much monkey business.
Boy, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Well, blonde hair, good looking, trying to get me hooked, want me to marry, get a home, settle down, write a book.
Whoa. Too much monkey business, too much monkey business.
Yeah, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Well, same day, every day, out of bed, go to school. No need to complain, my objections overruled.
Whoa, too much monkey business. Too much monkey business.
Yeah, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Let's hear that guitar. Yeah! Got some saxophone. Well, working in the filling station, too many tasks, quite the windows, check the tires, check the oil, dollar gas.
Huh. Too much monkey business. Too much monkey business.
Yeah, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Oh, yeah. Too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Oh, that's too much monkey business for me to be involved in. Thank you. Thank you, and welcome to CabaRay. And speaking of monkey business, there's no way to have too much of it when our guest is a former member of the 60s supergroup, The Monkees. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Micky Dolenz.
Hello. Ray. You know, my mom and dad were such big fans of yours.
Oh, really? How about your grandparents?
Yeah. Oh, this is such a pleasure to be here with you.
Well, it's so nice to have you.
I am and was such a huge fan.
Oh, well,
I'm quite thrilled to be here with you.
Well, I used to watch you guys every week on the television, and it's such a pleasure to have you on the show.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, I read someplace that Last Train to Clarksville was recorded at RCA Studio B, and I never realized that. And then I read a little further, and it was RCA Studio B in Los Angeles, in Hollywood.
Yes.
And
that's true.
But it was Clarksville, Tennessee, was it not?
It certainly was. Tommy Boyce lived in Tennessee, born and raised, and he wrote it about the Army base. It's essentially, you know, kind of an anti-war song, you know, about a soldier going off, off to Clarksville, boot camp at Clarksville, yeah.
Folks, I tell everybody, I've been in show business for 60 years, but this guy was an actor on TV when I was a junior in high school. he was Corky, the water boy, in a TV kids show called Circus Boy in 1956.
Yeah.
How did you get into this business at such an early age?
My parents were both in the business, actors, singers, and so I kind of followed in my father's footsteps, I suppose. Circus Boy was the first proper series that I had, proper paying job, but I'd done some auditions and stuff before that.
You know, The Monkees was such a fun show. How did all that come about?
Well, it was a pilot that year in Hollywood, in the pilot season. The auditions were 65, and it was in the air. Everybody wanted to, you know, get on that train, so to speak. And you had to be able to, well, obviously act and do comedy, but you had to also be able to sing and play.
Yeah.
And my audition piece was Chuck Berry, Johnny B. Goode. And then they said, when they cast me, they said, you're going to be the drummer. And I'm like, well, but I play guitar. And they said, well, we have a lot of guitar players. We don't need
Welcome to Nashville.
And I said, fine, where do I start? But I, you know, I knew music because I'd studied classical guitar. So I could read music and stuff. But again, I'd been born into the business.
Right. Didn't you have a lifelong friendship with Davy Jones?
Well, of course, yeah. We were both cast at the same time.
So you didn't meet Davy until you were cast as a monkey?
No. Oh, didn't meet anybody until we were cast. We were introduced one day, and they said, Micky, this is Mike, and this is Davy and Peter. And said, oh, hi, how you doing? Yeah, well, I remember from the auditions. And one morning, we were just all there at the first wardrobe call. You know.
Yeah.
And so, but Davy and I did, we did get along, and we did have a very close relationship because we both had similar backgrounds. We were both in the business, and he was a child star on television in England. And so we kind of connected, you know, with family and stuff, yeah.
So what did you do after The Monkees?
I went into production. I started directing and producing television, mostly in England. I moved to England and had a family there, and I directed, created, produced, wrote TV shows. And that's all I did for like almost 15 years.
Well, I can see you got over the language barrier.
You know, I loved it over there. It was wonderful. And it was great because it gave me the opportunity, even though that wasn't the plan, to back away from the monkey business, to you know, detach myself, as it were, and be able to look back on it eventually with great fondness. And you know, I was blessed to be a part of that show and a part of the music, and you know, it was a wonderful experience. And
you know, one of your big hits was written by Neil Diamond.
Yeah. And a couple of them.
I'm a believer.
Yeah, right? And a little bit me, a little bit you.
Yeah.
We had this, you know, unbelievable stable of writers that were writing for us, Carole King and Jerry Goffin.
Right. They wrote Pleasant Valley Sunday, right?
David Gates, Boyce and Hart, who wrote some of the biggest hits, like Clarksville.
Yeah.
and others, and the theme song. They wrote and produced the early Monkey songs.
Why don't you sing some of those hits for us?
Nah.
I think you will if you keep doing that.
No.
It's all yours, pal. What you do with it.
Thank you. Like I was saying, I was blessed to have some of the greatest songwriters ever writing for me. Carole King and Jerry Goff and Neil Diamond, Harry Nilsson, David Gates, Diane Hildebrand, Neil Sedaka, Neil Diamond, Neil Armstrong. He wrote Blue Moon. And a couple of guys that not only wrote some of the greatest songs we ever did, biggest hits, but wrote the theme song and were the producers of the early Monkey Records. And their names were Tommy Boyce and Bobby Hard. And I can't, you know, thank them both enough for blessed to have them involved in that project. And this one is by them, and this is the one that started it all. Take the last train to Clarksville. I'll meet you at the station. Be here by 4:30. I made your reservation. Don't be slow. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. 'Cause I'm leaving in the morning and I must see you again. We'll have one more night together till the morning brings my train and I must go. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. And I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Take the last train to Clarksville. Be waiting at the station. We'll have time for coffee, flavored kisses, and a bit of conversation. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. I can't hear you in this noisy railroad station all alone. I'm feeling low. No, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. And I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Don't be slow. No, no, no. No, no, no. And I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Thank you very much. Great song. Next one here is written by Carole King and Jerry Goff and her partner, and it's one of my favorite to sing and play. This is Pleasant Valley Sunday.
The
local rock group down the street is trying hard to learn their song. Serenade, the weekend squire just came out to mow his lawn. Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Chaco burning everywhere. Proud today, 'cause the roses are in bloom. Mr. Green, he's so serene, got a TV in every room. Another Pleasant Valley Sunday. Here instead of simple land, mothers complain about how is, and the kids just don't understand. Creature comfort goals only numb my soul. Net card for me to see. My thoughts all seem to stray to places far away. I need a change of scenery.
Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart.
Great song. Yeah, like I said, we had all these great writers, and one guy named Neil Diamond wrote a couple of the biggest hits we ever had. This one I want to do for you now, I wrote for me. It's called I'm a Believer. I want you to, if there's any kids out there in the audience, I want you to know, or you go home, you tell your kids or your grandkids, I sang this song long before Shrek. I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face. I'm a believer. Not a chase. Down in my mind. I'm a believer. a given thing. Seems the more I gave, the less I got. Oh, what's the use in trying? All you get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got a rain. I then saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace down in my mind. I'm in love. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. Well, all right. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace doubt in my mind. I'm in love. I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. Yes, I saw her. Thank you, Ray. Fabulous. Thank you so much.
Thank you. What a trip down memory lane, and thank you for coming to CabaRay. Let's hear it again. Micky Dolenz, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, several years ago, I recorded an album called Ray Stevens Sings Sinatra. Say what? And my concept was to record a lot of Sinatra songs, who always had a big orchestra, with a five-piece band, just to see what would happen, see how it would sound. And so I'd like to sing you one of the songs out of that album right here. Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down, but the secret is, don't worry about it. That's life. Yeah, that's what people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May, but I know I'm gonna change that tune.
Oh yeah.
Oh, when I'm back on top in June, I said that's life.
That's life.
Yeah, funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream, but I don't let it get me down. Cause you know this old world keeps on spinning around
and around and around.
Yeah, I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn, and a king. I've been up, down, over, and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, will I pick myself up and get back in the race? That's life. Can't deny it. I once thought of quitting, but my heart just wouldn't buy it. If I didn't think it was worth one single try, well, I'd just roll myself up in a big ball and die. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn, and a king. I've been up, down, over, and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, will I just pick myself up and get back in the race? That's life.
That's life.
Yeah, I can't deny it. I've thought about quitting, but my heart won't buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come July, well, I'm gonna roll myself up in a great big ball and die. You know, we've really had some terrific music on the show this week, and they are songs that are popular all over the world. You know, America exports a lot of stuff like our rock and roll, blues, jazz, country music, blue jeans. I wish we could export some of our TV commercials. Well, you can't win them all. Some of the strangest commercials are like Marie Osmond saying, "Bye-bye, stubborn belly fat." When I first saw that, I didn't know if it was for a diet program or a divorce lawyer. Oh, and here's one. What's in your wallet? Do they mean before or after I pay my credit card? And that couple in two different bathtubs out in the middle of the woods holding hands? Is it just me, or is this a classic example of bad judgment? I mean, when I see that, I don't think of romance. I think things like plumbing, poison ivy, bears. Well, we don't have to bother with commercials on this program, but we do have dancing, and it's time for me to find a pretty lady and dance us out of here. So thank you, and please tune us in again next time. Now I'm gonna go over here and see if this lady here would dance with me. Ma'am, would you do me the honor?
From Ray and the whole gang of CabaRay Nashville, I'm Bill Cody. So long till next time. Bye, guys.
Come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers.
So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.